Hey everybody, it's Later Life Dad here, and you probably remember this fountain right here. We did a really cool kind of oil stain coating on this concrete fountain, and what I'm going to do today is try and give it more of an antique look. So I'm going to take out my sander, we're going to go over it, make it look more distressed. So let me give you some close-up shots so you can see what this looks like real quick. All right, here we go. So I just tested a little bit out here, but I'm going to go over it with the sander, try and take some of this color off that I put on it. I know. I went to all that trouble to put the color on, but I thought I'm going to make it look a little bit more natural because I did it with my other fountain, which I think I'll upload that video here in the not too distant future. But I'm changing out the lights today. I thought, well, I'm down here and all this mess changing out the lights, I'm going to go ahead and do a little sanding, see if I can give it a little bit more of an antique look before I fill it back up with water. So just want to give you a look of what this is like. Get the pump out there. And then we're going to use my Makita sander. So I've got my sander here. Little hand sander. And I've got these discs here. If you don't know what this is, here's the box for it. I know what this is. And then this is the sanding discs here. I've got two different ones. I've got a 60 grit and 220. So this is finer and smoother. This is more coarse. I think I'm gonna start off with this to see how that goes. And then I'll go to the finer one. So we'll take a look at it. And we'll give this one a go here and see if we can get kind of more of a patina look or a more of a natural kind of a used look to this fountain. All right, be right back. All right, everybody, I'm gonna go ahead. We got our 220 sanding pad on, or 16 grit sanding pad, or 60. We got our 60 in here. Let's give a little look at what it does up here to the edge. So here we go. This is real worn from all the water over the years. I'm noticing it's starting to chip off some of the concrete because it's so worn. So you can get more of a used look, but I'll have to go easy on this one so I don't lose too much concrete. Chipping. So this concrete, look at that stuff. Oh my gosh, this concrete's not in the best of shape. I can take that out with my hands. So water is very destructive, everybody. So you got to be really careful with, plus, you know, depends what you run here. I do put chlorine in here, which probably isn't the best thing. It'll cause the concrete to degrade faster, but you can look at this concrete. Wow, that's not good. Maybe I won't even do this side over here. All right, let's try a little bit more. I'm going to do some up here. I'll switch to, let me try the 220. Well, this isn't that rough anymore. And that concrete's just really, really kind of beat up. All right, I'm gonna work on this a little more and I'll be right back. So I slowed down the speed instead of having up to 5. I'm gonna go a little bit lower while I work the detail on the lion's face. Lower RPMs, and I think it's gonna let me do more detail work here. And I can kind of adjust it as I go. I get a little bit in here. You can kind of angle the grinder a little bit to get in these little nooks and crannies. See, look here, I'm gonna get in an angle here. Look at this. See, it's kind of flexible, the edges. I can really get in here and do some grinding. Watch this one. There's some weak concrete right there. Let me get down in here. Alright, so I'll catch back up with you in a second. We'll see what kind of progress you're making. Okay guys, so this is pretty gritty paper here, but as this concrete really wears it down fast. So when you get down here, there's not a lot of grit left. When it's kind of worn down, this is a great time to use it up here on the detail, so you don't really take off a lot of detail. So I'm gonna now go over the details here with the softer pad, okay? So at a lower speed, so I've got the worn out pads at a lower speed. Look at this, can you give it a nice old rolled look? Getting in all the nooks and crannies. And let me show you why I'm doing this. I'm gonna turn on the hose, hold on. So, put some water here. I'll show you the reason why I'm doing this. Look at that. So you're getting that kind of look. See where you get the light and the dark. So it's gonna give it that real kind of cool old fountain look like you'd see in Italy or something. So I'm gonna hose off what I've done so far so I can see what I have to continue on doing. You see this bad concrete over here? Look at that stuff, it just comes off. That's just old, worn out concrete. So maybe I'll get rid of the bad stuff on the surface and we'll have better concrete under it, hopefully. But really, there it is so far. So you can kind of see we're starting to get some of that lighter color and getting rid of a lot of the orange color. So it's starting to look a little bit better. As it dries out, I think it looks even better. So I'm going to keep hitting it again and show you what else I'm going to do. So
Guys, got a new pad on 60 grit. We're gonna go up the sides here. So I want you to see kind of how we do the texture. I did a little bit, but check this out. So let's start right here. You see that? It's all dark orange here. I'm gonna go on this side so you can see it better. Get some of the front too. Look at that. It looks pretty cool. Getting in the groove. All right, I'll see you back in a second. We'll see how we're doing with our progress. All right, so you can see here we're starting to get some detail here and give it the weathered look. So it's looking pretty good. It's really going through this paper pretty quick. So just a heads up, you're probably gonna go through a lot of sanding, guess. And this is a 60 grit, the really tough one. So, but you can see it's starting to get that really cool look that I was kind of looking for. So let's see, we'll do a little bit more. You can check this out.
you just have to kind of, it's like an art. So you got to take off as much as you want while leaving the color on. So let me spray this down. Let's take a little look at it and see how we're doing.
All right.
Oh, we got to throw more water. Hold on. You can see it's really getting kind of nice. I'll probably have to go get some like steel wool or something to get in these little areas because the sanding is just like in here. But I think it's looking better already, don't you think?
Mm-hmm.
All right, cool. See you in a few. Okay. So I'm going to use a disc in my hands just to get these tight spots because the sander can't reach in these little areas. See this little stuff like here? And you can really kind of highlight these little areas here. Having hand. Now, the best thing is maybe if it's some steel wool or some other sandpaper, but I've only got these, so I'm just going to go with what I got. But it does work pretty good, as you can see. I mean, it really does a pretty good job. I think it's starting to look really good, though. I think we're getting to your things. And this might be something you might have to work on over weeks or months, as you can just kind of touch it up a little bit and you know, get it looking good. You can go over it time and again. But you can see I'm able to get in these little nooks and crannies that I wasn't able to with the big sander. So, like down here, look at this spot. You can kind of fold this like this and get in this little spot. Get on the top. There we go. Anyhow, looking good. Let's go ahead and I'm gonna hose this off. Let's take a quick look at it. Water here. All right. Here we go. Look at that. We're getting the kind of age look going here. It's looking a lot better, huh? Mm-hmm. All right, cool. We'll check back with you in a second as we go farther along.
All right, everybody. So here's the end results. What are you thinking? Looks pretty good, huh? Got some nice kind of texture here. It looks really good. It's a kind of antique look. Go for a close up here as well.
I think it looks pretty darn good. Not really nice. And I may go back over with some more sandpaper or maybe try some other stuff just to kind of highlight a little bit more. But I think it looks pretty darn good. We put our LED lights in here. You can get these on Amazon. So we can turn them on here. Then we'll little sensor down here. If you look on Amazon, you can see these little sensors, and I'll cover it up. There you go. You get kind of a blue light. Looks great at nighttime, but there's the lights. So, all right. Hope this inspires you. And Larry Life Dad here signing off. Thanks for watching, everybody, and we'll see you again soon. Take care.